You know you're bored when this is going to be your new sounds for your computer.
Skip it up and that up!
And of course, the unplug. Let's see if I can remember how to do this. Another issue I've noticed over time is the film feeling from around the FaceTime camera. Now I know Apple is I'll just be right back and do it myself. That, I'll explain it. Thanks to my secret formula. It's called okay, gotta figure it out. Another weird issue I've had is the light USB port will sometimes just stop working when you plug something into it. Now, it won't just they gotta be those types of files. There you go, go ahead and just change the file type. Sometimes it will just not acknowledge it. Not really sure why, but again, it didn't do that at first. It's about 7 years old, so it's a little forgettable. Also, to no surprise, the battery is kind of on its way out. Coconut battery reports the health usually between 75% and 80%, and it fluctuates.
These batteries are
about 5 years of use before you notice actual battery life issues. And I started noticing them maybe about a year ago for about 6 years. So it did its job quite all right, but it is starting to. Apple does have a rather program, so I'm sure I'll do that eventually. But now we come to the bigger problem, and this is what has been making me contemplate an upgrade. Yes, Final Cut Pro has been able to keep up very well, but I've moved all of my workflows over to 4K. Shooting 4K, exporting 4K, and it's starting to kind of bog down the system a bit, especially if there's multiple clips playing at once and there's color grading effects going on. The playback can sometimes be pretty choppy. Even in the better performance mode,
I guess it helps if I know what I'm actually doing here.
But it still does lag quite a bit whenever you're in 4K. Heck, even the audio sometimes will cut out all the time. You know, it's manageable. It's just, I'll be honest, for the past like 5 or 6 months or so, ever since I did the 4K transition, it's been a pain in the butt. 1080p though, no problem at all. You can just cut right through it. Another thing with 4K is export. Now the exporting time isn't terrible, but sometimes, generally I've noticed this when I have plugged into an external display. When I'm rendering 4K video,
skip it up and that up!
Kind of drop down, and it's kind of tough to use other applications while it's rendering in an external display. But what's even worse, when you're
rendering in an external
oops, now it's playing something in.
Skip it up and that up!
Nice, it worked.
But I'm gonna be.
But all of those issues I mentioned will be.
That's awesome. Like, this is what happens when I'm bored.